I will explain how to build a ceramic restoration with chairside milling machine in a dental clinic. So this milling machine has to cut the crown as fast as possible, so it is equipped with a milling tool at both sides, left and right side. So I will show you how to prepare for milling procedure before actual milling. So this is a changeable and block procedure. We can press the button in the software, and we can easily remove the milling tool. So we are replacing the previous one with new milling board. At the left side, if we push this button, this machine will hold the tool tight. So we equipped two drills for inner side and outer side, and I am connecting the tool. Connecting the material. This is the mandrel type material. So, and I'm connecting it with this tiny screw. So we finish it. Preparation procedure. Then this machine will calibrate the position of both drills and tools. Okay. So we finish a closing procedure. Then we can proceed to milling stage. So let me explain how to calculate the tool path with this built-in software. This is a name. This software is named D plus CAN. So we input patient information, and we import the design data into this calculation software. So we set the tooth number, and the design is imported here. We draw cavity side, internal side first. Normally, the computer automatically detects the cavity side and margin line automatically, but I'm showing you the manual selection to help you your understanding. After we select the cavity side, and then we double click this side, then the computer automatically click, and the computer will understand this is internal side, and we set the path of insertion. So we have to select the best angulation for a milling process. So we set this direction as path of insertion. So this is the line, and we have to set. This is a head of insertion line, and we have to set the screw connection shape, so we can move and select the best position. We can rotate the crown, and we can set the point here. The milling machine cuts occlusal side and cavity side, and after we finish milling, this connection holds the whole milled restoration, so we have to select the best position that can hold the final product well. So we can increase or decrease the thickness of connection part. So this is a buccal bowl, so we do not set the connection part here, because we have to grind it out after milling. We have to preserve this detail. So we finalized screw positioning. And this side, I previously set the burrs, inner burr and outer burr, and there is a block name. We will mill magic jewel block from Vericom. This is South Korea company. Then we select the machine, milling machine, and we select the block name and size. Then we can copy the calculated toolpath data into milling machine. This is a toolpath we calculated with this software. The blue color is inner cavity size milling path, and the orange color is occlusal side milling path. And fine path and rough path. There are four milling paths in this calculation. So if finalized toolpath calculation with this software. Okay. We have to prepare abutment tools very well without any undercut. If the restoration has undercut, the machine cannot cut those area. So we have to do well. So we push the start button, then the machine calculates the milling tool with material. The calculated toolpath data is transferred from computer to milling machine via LAN line. And the machine will cut this material according to the calculated toolpath data. So the machine will calculate or detect the material first. If the correct material is connected in the machine, so we selected magic jewel block from Vericom company, size 12. So this machine had to calculate the dimensions with these connected tools. So it is detecting the width between this and this. and if the machine confirms that the right milling board is connected and the right material that we previously selected is connected, then this machine will begin actual milling process. They are detecting X, Y, and Z. So it is detecting Z axis dimension. It takes time. It takes about 20 minutes for milling, and the time is very important, but this sensing procedure is important, because if we fail to mill the block, we have to consume another block and consume another time. So this sensing procedure might feel it is unnecessary and it is it takes time, but it is very important step. Approaching to detect the position in micron level. So it is Z axis detection. Finally, it touched the surface and it detected the alignment between tool and material, then the milling procedure begins. This is cavity side, and this is occluder side. So it is built simultaneously, and we can reduce milling time because both sides are milling at the same time. And this is a wet milling, and this machine utilizes a solution, water, cooling water, cooling and lubricant. With a solution to facilitate the speed. So it is because of this water, we cannot see clearly the milling procedure, but the machine is quickly grinding the material, tissue side, cavity side, and occluder side. Okay. And they are using stepped board, 1, 2, 3 steps. So the computer will computer just calculated the tool path while fully utilizing the shape of milling board. So I explained what we are doing during chair side milling. So we have to calculate. We have to prepare for milling procedure. We have to check the tool and material itself. Then we have to calculate the tool path from design data, and we have to transfer the data to milling machine. Then the milling machine checks the relative position between among tools and material. Then the milling begins, procedure begins, and it takes about 20 minutes for milling 1 crown or 1 inlays. Okay.